10:15 in the morning when gunshots rained down from a building rooftop on a 4th of July parade in the downtown area of Highland Park in Illinois. At first, parade goers thought it was the usual celebratory fireworks, but soon after seeing people running and screaming, they realized it was their worst nightmare.
We're getting ready to march down the street, and then all of a sudden waves of these people started running after, like running towards us. And right before that happened, we heard the pop, 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 pop. And I thought it was fireworks.
Six people were confirmed dead with at least 24 injured. The youngest victim, 8 years old. The oldest, 85. Hours after the shooting, police finally apprehended a person of interest, 22-year-old Robert Cremo III, who is already being considered a suspect in the shooting. Citing the latest mass shooting, U.S. President Joe Biden, during his 4th of July speech at the White House, said the work to eliminate gun violence is far from over.
Before I left for Europe, I signed a law, the first real gun safety law in 30 years. And things will get better still, but not without more hard work together. Y'all heard what happened. Y'all heard what happened today. But each day, we're reminded there's nothing guaranteed about our democracy.
Residents of Highland are now feeling the pain and paranoia. They never thought it would happen in their city.
I am worried about my community and about schools. Like, my brother is in high school, and to be honest, I'm scared about him.
The state of Illinois is home to many Filipinos, but the upscale small suburban town of Highland is not known to have many Filipinos. There's no word yet from the Philippine consulate in Chicago nor the Philippine embassy if there were any Filipinos affected by the latest mass shooting. TJ Manotok, ABS-CBN News.